People want to see him in there with Vasyl Lomachenko. If you saw Vasyl Lomachenko's performance this past Saturday, what did you think of it, and how would he fare against Mikey Garcia?
You know, it is what it is. You know, he fought a little guy. What's his name? Complains about his hand was hurt. But I think Mikey and Lomachenko, I think Mikey outboxed him.
Yeah.
You know, Mikey,
yeah. Or, yeah. Or big, or bigger or same size.
Big, you know, he's a bigger fighter. You know, I mean, you look at his fundamentals and skills, you know, how relaxed he is, how he works his jab, you know, I think he beats him.
Another guy from Northern California, Andre Ward, said about coming back to the ring, you can never say never. Then when he walked back to Mandalay Bay, kind of like brought back the memories of his last fight with Bobolo. Have you got that point yet, where you come into the gym and you're like, oh man, maybe one more?
I was looking at pictures the other day and I seen an old picture of me when I was 21 years old. I'm like, man, those are the days. And I got that feeling like, man, maybe one more. My wife just shut it down. She goes, you're done. Retirement, that's it. You're retired. But you know what? I enjoy the commentating and, you know, being around the ring and being around the fight. So, you know, it's
Robert,
good.
Robert, what did you think?
I won't come back.
What did you?
Oh, look at me. I still
don't know what about training in the corner as a trainer.
Oh, you know, just working with younger fighters. You know, the guy that I'm working with, Efron Lopez, they call him Chico, you know, doing a good job. You know, I enjoy it also, you know. I think some of the best trainers are fighters, you know, because they've been in there. They've experienced it, movements, different things you can teach them. It's just having that patience.
What did you think of Bob Arum's praise of Lomachenko? He says he hasn't seen anything like it, not even when Ali fought, not even when Pacquiao fought Mayweather. What did you make of it? Now a lot of people, they're comparing the Mayweather at 130 to Lomachenko at 130. They're pairing them up. You fought Mayweather, I know at 147, but still, what do you make of that scenario? But
you know, there's only one Mayweather, man. Dude, his speed, his hand speed, his foot speed, you know, his unorthodox, just how he changes direction. You know, it's hard to match that.
Yeah.
It's hard to match that, you know. Machenko's his own fighter. He's a very good fighter. You know, one of the best in the world. His skills are phenomenal, and, you know, I think he's his own man.
Yeah.
I talked to your brother. How's your dad doing? He told me about the accident he had. That sounded pretty nasty.
Yeah, you know, he fell through the roof. You know, busted his ribs, his collarbone, you know, had some damage. But that kind of got me into the training, too, is because, you know, I got to step up for my dad and help him out until he's back on his feet. But he's doing really well. You know, he's doing well. He's, you know him, he's a tough guy, man.
Yeah, that sounded pretty
Robert,
bad.
You fought everyone, man. What's the one fight or the one performance that sticks out that you just say that was my night, or that was my greatest moment, my career defining moment?
I don't know. All of them, man.
Yeah.
You know, when you're a fighter, you're a fighter. You know, win, lose, you know, you put up a good fight, you make it happen. That's it, man. You enjoy them all. You know, you just look back and go, damn, I did this good, I did that good, I didn't do that good. You know, you just look at it and you just enjoy the career, man.
Yeah. All right, thank you so much. I'll see you the next time around.
Yeah.
Appreciate you, Robert. Thank you.
Yeah.